adolescence growing up in a small, predominantly white town made me feel kind of disconnected and isolated at times. I'm so grateful to have spent my adolescent years in such close proximity to nature because it's always been there to hold and support me. It's been the thing I've always called on to soothe loneliness, sadness, or anxiety. I remember getting home from school as a young teenager and riding my bike down to the river along the gravel road lined with gum trees. I remember the way the breeze would flow against my skin and gently tussle my hair, hurling me into a sense of carefree contentment as I toss my head back and stare upwards at the glimmering sun playing hide and seek through the treetops. In this way, nature has always offered me a softness and a spaciousness that I struggle to find in other parts of life. I'm going to be moving overseas in the next few weeks, and I feel a deep yearn in me to escape and rest in that familiar sense of ease that nature continually offers me one more time before uprooting my life and finding my feet in a new place.
Anne is now in police custody after an abduction in Perth and a gorilla.
Wrestling was first a thing, everybody thought it was real.
Don't rush everything in this divine time. I am peace, you couldn't handle a woman in the kind of ball has to leave.
I've arrived, and I think I found the perfect patch of grass because look, the river is right there. There's nobody else staying at this campsite, so it's literally just me in this huge paddock. Like, isn't that so fucking cool? Okay, let's set up the tent.
I put a tent here, and then where am I gonna put my table? Put my table over there in front of the river.
I finally finished setting up, set up my tent. I've got like the fire ready so I don't have to worry about finding sticks later on. It's 2:40 in the afternoon now. I've got my bag of activities here. I've got so many things in here. I've got my sketchbook, I've got my journal. I've got two books because I've been reading this book. Oh, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings by Maya Angelou, but I'm almost finished it. So I bought a new book, Go Tell It on the Mountain by James Baldwin. And so I've got those, and I've got my speaker. I've also got some shroom chocolate, which I think I will have. I was umming and ahhing of whether I should have the shroom chocolate today or not, because it's kind of later in the afternoon, and ideally I'd want to like start in the morning and have like more time to be tripping, but maybe I'll have those. And so I think that the aim of the game for the rest of the day is literally just to sit here. I guess I will have the shroom chocolate. Sit here, have the shroom chocolate, and chill. Doing shrooms, I swear to God, go through this tunnel of fucking darkness to get to the light. It's hectic. Ugh. It's been an hour since I had the chocolate, and many tears,
I've been fucking just lying on my rug in my pillow with my hoodie on, just like this, like in a hole. And I feel like I'm finally coming back to life. I feel like you just become so introspective and like inward. I think that being alone is just making me feel really like, wow, it's really just me. Like, I don't know how to explain this feeling. I'm just amongst it. Like, it's neither good nor bad. I just feel like I'm just here. Like, I can't fucking explain it. Look at me trying to talk. This is not gonna work. I'm literally just standing in this paddock talking to myself, and I was crying my eyes out just before in my pillow, just like feeling kind of alone, feeling very lonely, but not in a really like a sad way, just like in a way that is like, it's just you in the world, like finding your way. But it's nice just to be like in a space of no self-judgment and not criticizing myself and just literally just being in like the purest sense. I think that I start to feel so like so in touch with it all, and like so like everything is so stripped back to a point where it's like if you think about like an animal or like a leg of lamb, right? Saying that life is a leg of lamb, I feel like doing shrooms like takes away all of the meat off of the leg of lamb until it's just the bone, and that can feel really scary to be so like exposed and so like, yeah, so exposed. Life is a leg of lamb, hey? It's a feeling of vulnerability and a feeling of, yeah, like nakedness, vulnerability to the world. I think it's so humbling. Like, that is what I would say this feeling is. I feel fucking humbled by life right now. I need to put some music to like dance and like shake it up, you know? I feel very in my head and very serious right now. Here we go.
What do people tend to dance? With this music, I'll put you in a trance.
Hey!
And now the light shines
bright.
And that way we'll clear a day, the darkest night.
To make a living.
Hey, you are. Well, I wonder if you know that I'm your sweet, sweet darling. And all that you wear,
feel free.
So move on.
I don't stop.
Such a
self free. What would life be without fucking music? Oh, tunes after tunes after tunes. Doobop sound, just kicking that doobop sound with Miles Davis. Look at that. So fucking beautiful. Literally feels like something biblical. Incredible. Incredible. Wow, the mountains, the clouds, the sky, the trees, all of it. Wow. That was a good playlist. What do we want next? I need to start cooking dinner soon because shit's getting dark and I need to see what I'm doing to make dinner. Thank you. dinner now. Dinner time. Everybody has got to make a living. Oh, I just stepped in cow shit. There's cow shit fucking everywhere. My socks are having it. My socks are fucking having it. The ingredients, a knife. We're making chorizo pasta. So I've got chorizo, I've got tomatoes, I've got pasta. Okay, now we're gonna let that saute in the pan. Delicious. Where's the salt? Aquí es la sal. Some salt in the pasta water. The sun has set. How sad. Okay, so we've got, let me just show you what's going on, yeah? So we've got the chorizo and the cherry tomatoes and the garlic and the oil, all that's in the pan, and it's all just cooking along very nicely. Think, what is that?
What is that? Is that a wall? Oh, it's like a, is it a hole? God knows what that is. Didn't know my camera could zoom that far, bloody hell.
Okay, hey. You know what I need? I need a camera crew. Okay, tomato paste. It's not open, fancy that. Hey, Tomato paste, going in the pan. Lovely. Mix it up. To be honest, I think it needs to cook a bit longer. Put it back on the fire. And we just dance, because everything is good. All is well with the world. All is well. The moon is in like such a beautiful little crescent. It's like a slither. Pasta water going straight in the pan. See that smoke? That's what you want. Let's have a look. Enjoyment. That looks so good. I'm gonna leave that aside now and put the pasta on. Get the pasta on the boil. Gotta get some water from my little water can. Put the, it's all fucking jiggly jangly. Get the pasta on the boil. That, we're gonna let that sit for about 10 minutes. Meanwhile, let's go light the fire. Okay, so a lovely girl named Cameron, she actually set this up for me earlier, which is so kind of her. Thanks, Cameron, for thinking out for us. This is the things you've gotta do when you're alone, yeah? Just gotta make yourself entertaining. There we go. I've got a little fire lighter in there, some grass, some twigs, and then I've made a nice little teepee design for the fire to climb up nicely. See, it's coming up. And then I've got some bigger logs here, which we're gonna gradually add on later. Hello.
together with hustle, with struggle, with truth. Why not just get together and live in one love and one identity, you know? Man says a great adventure here, dear, and everywhere you can hear more when
I shot the sheriff, but I didn't shoot the deputy.
Not eat all of this. This is so much food. Yum! Now, shall we pull up a seat by the fire that we made? Me data, eh? I could just sit right here.
Lord, give me water, eh?
I'm so thankful for this plate of food. Wow. What did I do to deserve this?
Buffalo soldier,
hey.
In the heart of America. Stolen from Africa.
I've had such a wonderful evening. When the trip started, I felt such a wave of doom and anxiety. About what? Nothing in particular, just awash with a sense of loneliness and emptiness. Like I was suddenly stripped back to the core and all of me was bare and exposed. Scary. But from there we rose, danced, made dinner, made a fire, danced some more, felt so in touch with life. It's funny how complex the human mind is. So many thoughts all at the same time, fighting for the stage. Now I'm sitting by the fire amongst the darkness, under the starry sky, fire ablaze. It's crazy because I used to be so afraid of the dark, but here I am in it. A part of me does feel anxious and afraid. It's that bare and naked feeling, so exposed. Good morning. Oh, my camera ran out of battery, so we're on the camcorder. But I don't know, when you wake up camping, I'm kind of like, what next? Like, I don't really have any breakfast food and I kind of ran out of water. So I kind of have to leave, but I've got my strawberries here. Wow, they look so fucking good. Reintegrate back into society. I feel like I'm the only person on the planet right now, and it feels really nice. Let's go and get a coffee. I'm just eating avocado, salt, lemon, and mackerel. It's a random combination, but it tastes so good. And so good for you. And also surprisingly very filling. This is a beautiful moment. I'm just on the side of this road. There's nobody here. Went for a swim. I'm feeling fresh. I'm eating. I just feel good. I feel so good. And look, it's such a beautiful day, blue sky.
this is one of those moments in life that feels like a movie. Like, this doesn't feel like reality.
It's time to hit the road in a second. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I've had the best time. I feel so good. See you later.